taking two doses of Covishield and planning to take Sputnik as a booster dose? Or mixing Covaxin and Covishield? Don't even think of it, says the World Health Organization.
It's a little bit of a dangerous trend here where people are in a data-free, evidence-free zone as far as a mix and match. There is limited data on mix and match. It will be a chaotic situation in countries if citizens start, you know, deciding when and who they should be taking a second or a third or a fourth dose.
The WHO says there is no data to show mixing and matching of different vaccines has any great benefits. Experts in India agree.
Body ko dusre vaccine se khub reaction ho, kharabi kar sakta hai. Ye ek scientific consideration hai ki kya aise ho sakta hai. Khaskar ek dusra vaccine jo alag platform ka bana ho. दूसरी और साइंस ये भी इंडिकेट करती है कि यहां ए मिला और बी मिलने से इम्यूनिटी ज्यादा आती है, ये भी दिखाया गया, फायदा भी दिखाया गया. मिक्सिंग ऑफ वैक्सीन इज नॉट अ प्रोटोकॉल. हम वही वैक्सीन लगाएंगे दूसरी बारी जो पहली बारी लगा है.
बट द डिबेट ओवर टेकिंग टू डिफरेंट वैक्सीन इज इनकंक्लूसिव. A trial on 600 participants showed that if Pfizer's mRNA vaccine is given as the second dose to those who took an AstraZeneca shot, it improved immune response significantly. The makers of Sputnik V in Russia also back a vaccine cocktail.
We are open to a mix and match approach with Covishield vaccine in India. We believe that it can produce a great result. Serum will be able to produce, Sputnik V and Sputnik V for mix and match approach and Sputnik V for booster approach.
Several European nations, Canada and South Korea have allowed the use of a different vaccine for the second dose.
What researchers have found that if a different platform vaccine, let's say a viral vector vaccine, is followed by a mRNA-based vaccine, while the safety profile remains the same, essentially there is no difference in adverse events if a different vaccine is given. However, the amount of antibody generated with a different vaccine as a second shot is far higher. This has a real practical implications and utility.
The belief is that combinations could potentially provide wider protection against certain mutations or variants. In the short term, mixing vaccines would also address problems of shortage. Right now, scientists and experts say that the problem with mixing vaccines against COVID-19 is that there is little data to show what permutations and combinations work. There are just too many unknowns. Mixing of vaccines can lead to side effects that can be surprising, maybe even deadly. We just do not know. What is required is that the government must make an effort, experts say, to generate more data and rely on science to then take a call.
Only those vaccines which have been studied through the prime boost approach through clinical studies should be used as a mixed vaccine or interchangeably. Not every vaccine. We cannot determine. Individuals should not decide themselves. The government should decide based upon scientific evidence.
Mixing of vaccines is not a new idea. It was recommended for some diseases like Ebola. But the jury is still out on whether it's going to help the fight against COVID. With Milind Sharma in New Delhi, Sneha Moldani for India Today.